Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, we are here back in the masjid, mashallah, to pray Jumu'ah again. And we are able to pray. We hope and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will give us continuous opportunity of opening the masjid and praying in Jama'ah and Jumu'ah, inshallah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take away this musibah from us. Once masjid is open again, we are all happy, alhamdulillah. And this happiness is a sign of Iman. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted from us anything related to your deen and iman, your akhirah, you get from anything of Islam, which is good, then you rejoice it. As he said in the Quran, say, in the bounty of Allah and in His mercy, in that let them rejoice, which is better than what they accumulate. So the Muslims allowed to rejoice, to express his happiness to Allah once we get this ni'am of the deen. Alhamdulillah ala ni'mat al-hidayah wa al-iman. Many of us today is here to pray, while many of our brothers and sisters, many of us who have lost their beloved one, they are not able to come here. Allah have accepted them for akhirah. They have no more opportunity left to pray two rak'ah. Everybody, when they die, they beg to Allah, oh Allah, I was not ready. Ya Allah, I'm not ready. Even you and me, when you feel some kind of pain in the chest, little bit, you are worried. You say, oh, subhanAllah, I was not ready for today. Oh Allah, don't take me today. So they are worried more when they know this is their final time. They cry to Allah, they cry to Allah. While we cry for them, they are not crying for us. They're crying to Allah, begging to Allah, oh Allah, give me bit of extension, one day, 2 days, so I can do tawbah, I can do so much charity, I can do tawbah from my sin, I can increase little bit of la'ali amal saliha, so I could do something goodness, Ya Allah. I was not ready, Allah, I didn't prepare myself. Everybody of them are crying. Alhamdulillah, we are still here. Allah has given us opportunity. Every day, every night is an opportunity for us to get so much for ourselves, for our akhirah. I'd like to focus, you know, day before yesterday probably, we are praying Zuhr. A brother was crying inside the salah, in Jama'ah, loudly, loudly. So I remember when somebody dies, you know, sometimes people scream, crying loudly, wailing, which is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it is haram, it is punishment for the mayyit. It is big, major sin for those who are crying. So we'd like to focus, what will give benefit to our beloved one, our deceased? What will cause harm to them, always cause harm to us? Focusing from some of the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In one of the ahadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا مَاتَ الْإِنسَانُ إِنْ قَطَ عَمَلْهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ. When a man dies, his good deeds come to an end, except for three. Sadaqah in jariya, a continuous charity. Aw ilmin intafa'u bihi, knowledge by which people derive benefit after his death. Aw waladin salihin yad'u lahu, or pious son or daughter who prays for him. These three things mentioned in this hadith, and more elaboration came especially about sadaqah jariya in the next hadith. Again, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna mimma yalhaq al-mu'mina min amalihi wa hasanatihi ba'da mawtihi." The rewards of the good deeds that will reach a believer after his death are, number one, ilman 'allamahu wa nasharahu, knowledge which he taught and spread. Number two, a waladan salihan tarakahu, a righteous son or daughter whom he leaves behind. Number three, Mushafan warathahu, a copy of the Quran that he leaves as a legacy. Nowadays, leaving a copy of the Quran probably is not that much, you know, a hard thing to do. In the olden days, when there was no printing machine, people would be writing with their hand. Finding a copy of Mushaf of the Quran was not so easy. At that time, it's more rewardful. Even though today could be also, it is very rewardful. Number four, aw masjidan banahu, a mosque that he built, or even contributed in building the mosque, or the maintenance of the mosque. And number five, أَوْ بَيْتًا لِبْنِ السَّبِيلِ بَنَاهُ, a house that he built for wayfarers. Nowadays, journey, traveling from one country to another country, much easier. Remember olden days, when people are walking or using some kind of animals, camel or whatever it is, hundreds of miles is not so easy at that time. So they needed a journey break, and that was some kind of houses built for the musafirin to take rest, to get some water, to eat something. That was a very good deed at that time. Rasulullah ﷺ mentioned that is one of the good deeds. Even nowadays, there are journey breaks we need. We have it from one city to another. But if somebody does, fi sabilillah, mashallah, much more rewardful. And the next one, aw nahran ajrahu, or a canal that he dug. It's a canal for the water, especially there is drought and there is no water easily available to make facility of the water. It could be a canal, it could be a pond, it could be a water well. So any kind of providing water to the people when they are in need. And number seven, صَدَقَةً أَخْرَضَهَا مِمَالِهِ مِفِي صِحَّتِهِ وَحَيَاتِهِ يَلْحَقُهُ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهِ, or a charity that he gave during his lifetime when he was in good health, not just when last breath is starting, he knows doctor said you have 3 days to live only, then he's giving a lot of charity, making wills nowadays. That could be good as well. But much better is you do when in earlier, when you are not worried that you are dying tomorrow or within days, you are in good health, that time making a will to give charity is something very rewardful. These deeds will reach him after his death. So these are the beneficial things we can do for somebody who we love, somebody who is our parents or our beloved or our dearest one. These are the things we need to do for them, in the according to the hadith. And there are some other things we should not do, which will cause harm to ourselves and our dearest one. For example, wailing when they die, crying loudly, as we said, quietly crying, no problem. Loudly crying, al-mayyit yu'adhabu bi bukai al-hayy. Number two, making good dua for them. We can do dua for our parents, we can do dua for any other Muslims, those who died long ago, those who died recently, for all of them. As in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم والذين جاءوا من بعدهم يقولون ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان. And those who came after them, after them, they say, our Lord, forgive us and our brothers who have preceded us in Iman, who died before us with Iman, Allah, forgive them. So this dua is allowed. That's why you do dua in janazah. That's why you do qabr ziyara. These are very useful. It gets the reward, that reward reaches to them, and we are also rewarded. Giving sadaqah, which came in the hadith. But what is not allowed also, that to bring some kind of structure on the grave. The grave should be very plain, no structure, no tomb. You found in Muslim world, there are tombs on the Muslim's grave, and they think this is something very good. This is against Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent Ali radiallahu anhu in Medina, O Ali, go and check if any structure raised on the any grave, diminish them. Okay? Bring them down. And he gone and checked. Where is anywhere, any structure on the grave, he finished it, and he came back to report to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Nowadays, Muslims are, they don't think what will give benefit to them and to their dearest one in Akhirah. They do respect their beloved one who died. With so much cultural activities or matters which is practiced by those who have no iman in Allah, neither they know what will happen in Akhirah, is any Jahannam, is there anything called Jannah, they're not worried about this, anything above the, on the surface of this planet. Nothing about Akhirah. So they do what they are, to celebrate their death anniversary, birth anniversary, and, you know, giving all these flower buckets to their pictures, to their photos, and to respect them, bow down to them. This is respecting the mayyit. And furthermore, bringing big statues. The more statue you make, the more big you make, the more respect to the mayyit. This is the concept of the people who doesn't believe in Allah, neither in Akhirah. A Muslim should not do think this to this way. Okay? That because it is the statue is bring people to do respect and honor, and the way it is leading to the shirk. In Arabia, there are a lot of statues and idols, all of are broken by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This Ummah of Tawheed cannot bring a statue. And that is not respect to your mayyit. That is disrespect. That is causing harm to himself, and you will be also, you know, causing yourself harm to yourself, making it. La'an Allahu al-musawwirin, those who make some kind of, you know, drawing or making any kind of human image. Allah, may Allah curse them. This is the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Even without your basic need to have the image, photos, as you said, of your father, your mother, to hang on the wall of your door, all this not allowed. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not entering Mother Aisha radhiyallahu anha's room because she used a new curtain of her window, which includes images of some of the animals, not human images, maybe horse and some other things. He said, Aisha, I cannot enter to your room until you remove that. Even human, you know, the images of the animals to display, to make this way, is not allowed. And it is curse of Allah is mentioned, how people will be making the statues in many of the Muslim countries. They will make this kind of statues to respect to their beloved one. Following the culture of the other nations, those have no concept of Tawheed, neither they believe in Akhir anything. So, brothers and sisters, if we respect our beloved one, there is a beautiful way to help them, to help yourself, and to abstain from what is not allowed for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-afwa wal-afiyata fi dini wa-dunya wal-akhira, tawaffana muslimina wa-arhamna bis-salihin. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا واتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.